we're about to go do a yard that has some history with me. I was able to make three cool videos from this yard. One of them was when the starter on my Gravely Zero Turn broke, and I had to push the mower up the ramp by myself. So I had to push a zero turn alone, and there's dump valves on the hydros and stuff like that. So I was able to do that. That's one video. And I think we were able to talk about what had happened, and they actually fixed it right then on the spot. So that's a cool video. So I'll link to that, and you guys can check that out. A little bit later on, I did a video doing at this same yard. I did a video with a broken arm, and my arm was in a sling, and I did the entire yard with one arm. Sorry about the wiper. With one arm. I cut with the zero turn, I edged and weed-eated and blew off with one arm. And so that's worth watching. I'll go ahead and link to that right up here. And then the third video I did at this particular yard is where a dodo brain across the street. Let me let this car go by me. Go ahead, honey. Go ahead. A dodo brain across the street from where I was parked came backing out of his driveway and hit my truck with his truck, and old boy witnessed the whole thing, and the guy drove away. So I ended up calling the police because I knocked on the door just, you know, so the guy could come back and apologize at least, you know, and just be a freaking human being about the whole situation. And of course, it turned into this big deal. She says she doesn't know who he was. He doesn't stay there. The guy lives there. The truck lives there. I mean, I live here. I know the guy lives there. So then I called the police because now I'm pissed. So now I want to report, and I want to ruin this guy's day because they're just a bunch of liars. You backed into my car. Have a little bit of integrity. Just a little. You don't have to have a lot. Just have a little. And so I hemmed him up for that. And I'll link to that video up here as well. But I ended up not making an insurance claim or anything like that. I just wanted him to admit fault, for Christ's sakes. Just say I'm sorry. And he never did. So, whatever. What a jerk. So, this yard goes back with a little bit of history with me and you. So, let's go ahead and do its final cut for the season. And send him off to Thanksgiving with a nice looking yard. Guys ever get into this fidget spinning? Oops. What about all the things you could do with a fidget spinner? Or while you're fidget spinning? Thank you. we'll have to explore this fidget spinning lawn mowing a little more. A month since I did these yards because of the time of year, but the edges are a little bit kind of screwy, so I'm just kind of going through and cleaning up the edges a little extra good, you know. So you might see me like doing things and you're like, why are you going back over and over? Just cleaning them up, man. I'm in no rush. Extra weed eating because I don't feel like messing with that with the mower, having to go underneath the limbs. I could trim the limbs up, but I didn't bring my loppers with me. Cleaning up a fence line. Tell me if you guys remember this from past videos. Have a hammer? overkill, but and your questions are, why do you edge first? Why do you weed eat first? Why not mow first and then just go back over it with the weed eater when you're done, you know, to clean it all up and whatever? Well, there's no actual rhyme or reason to what I do. Like, I don't always do it a particular way. Sometimes it depends on the condition of the yard. I mean, if it's really bad, then I want to edge, weed eat, trim the bushes, grind the weeds, clean up the cracks of the sidewalk. I want to do all that and then blow it all in so the mower cleans it all up. While I'm mowing, it's doing the final cleanup as well, you know what I'm saying? I don't have a bunch of debris to take away. But if the yard's in good shape, it's a crapshoot. I'll usually always edge first or edge before I weed eat, so that way I can use the weed eater to clean up the edges if anything gets missed. But as far as mowing before I weed eat or weed eat before I mow, if it's a standard yard and it's in good shape, it all depends on how I feel. You know, sometimes the easiest thing to do is mow, regardless of your mower. It's a mindless job. You just mow. You're just mowing. You're putting down stripes or you're mowing straight lines or whatever. It's mindless. You just do it. You can listen to your music and just knock it out. Weed eating and edging and trimming bushes, you've got to concentrate. Do it right. You know what I'm saying? So getting the weed eating done, getting the edging done, getting everything done to where all you got to do is mow, it's kind of like mentally easier, I guess you could say. Like, all I got to do now is just go down the side yard, weed eat the backyard, and it's like I'm done. Because now all I got to do is just mow, and mowing simple. So it's like a mental thing with me. Another question you guys have is, why do I weed eat along the edges? Why do I border the yards like this? Because every edge is different. Sometimes you have a tall edge, and if you run your mower wheels down on the bottom, if you run your mower wheels on the pavement or the concrete, the blade might burn the edge. So you want your wheels to be up on the grass. And if that happens, you might miss a little bit. So if you go with your weed eater and give yourself 6, 4, 5, 8 inches of space there, you make a nice clean edge with your blade, your edge or blade, nice clean edge. And you have room for error with your mower. You don't have to hang it over. That's especially true with big mowers, multi-blade mowers. You don't want to mess up stuff like that, you know, edges and burn them. So you want to have a nice square finish. So if you look here, it's a nice, everything's nice and squared off. So I don't have to run the mower off the edge. Now, I can, but I don't have to. And if I can't because of it being really thick, or maybe the grass is lower than the sidewalk in some places, like this. A lot of times your driveway or your sidewalk might be higher than the actual grass. So you'll never have a nice clean edge. It won't cut right. So do it first with the weed eater, or do it after with the weed eater. But just the second that it takes to run and do it makes a world of difference. Arsenal that we're using today, we're using this older than dirt, what is this thing, 2 years old now? Maybe three, two? I think 2 years. Two full seasons on this thing. Now granted, this season wasn't like last season. Last season was psycho. This $378 Troy Built TB360 rear wheel drive, side discharge, bagger, mulch, 190cc braking Stratton motor has made me tens of thousands of dollars. So $378. I've done maintenance to it. I got videos. I'll link to them right here. That'll link to the playlist of changing the belt, changing the blade, the transmission belt and the blade and the adapter and oil and everything. I don't know. I really recommend you guys check it out and really check out these Troy Built mowers. They don't make the TB360 anymore, but they have comparable models out there. So the blower we're using, BG86 by Steel, handheld blower, $250. Awesome. Awesome machine. Once I got that, I got rid of my backpack blower. Love it. The weed eater. The FS100RX, straight shaft, steel, weed eater, and we're using the steel Combi 90. What is this? KM90R. KM90R. And that's the Combi with the edger attachment right here. I got the weed eater attachment if I needed it. You could put a hedge trimmer, you could put a blower, you could put all types of stuff on this. It's a four mix motor. The FS100 is also a four mix motor, so it has valves and everything. It's very low torque, you don't have to have it wound out. This is a two stroke motor. All right.
Thank you. zip tie on the boot of the spark plug, pull the zip tie, and it won't bite you. The cable broke. I replaced it once, it broke again. F it, who cares? All right, so we got this one done. No rush. It's just a beautiful day. Beautiful fall day. Looks pretty good.
Looks really good, actually.
And what'll happen is we might get some weeds here and there starting to pop up. This yard don't really have too many weeds. But when I send him his invoice, I will let him know that that's it. That's the last cut. And I won't be back until mid-March. And so it'll be up to him to notify me if he wants me to come back and do some type of a cleanup of any sort for any holiday festivities he may have. Totally up to the client. But I will email them and I will let them know that there will be no price increase. I will be back mid-March, unless I hear from you sooner. And please pay your final balance, like net 15 or something like that. Give them 15 days to pay their final invoice, which is only this cut. So that'll be it. Cool? Cool. I'll see you guys on the next one. Thank you.